So, welcome back to another episode on the Hermitcraft server. I hope you enjoyed the time lapse in the beginning. That was a lot of fun to record, especially goofing around with F5. I hope you enjoyed that bit. That did make me laugh. But I did finish building all of this. I lost the last bit of my footage. I don't know what happened. I hit record. I finished building this and then it wasn't on my hard drive. So I have actually finished building this. But this episode, we are going to be super busy. There is a lot to do because I've been pranked. We have to go and check that out. And also, I'm going to be starting my new base. So 1.7, or at least the snapshot for it, is out. And so you can probably tell that I've made up my mind. I've seen the new biomes and none of them really appeal to me. And since seeing them, I realized what was cool about the base and the idea for the project that I had there is that I was making my own biome, you know? I was making my own environment for the base to be in. And no biome could come along and really replace that in any way. Unless there was a wasteland biome, of course, which would be highly tempting to move there because half the work would have been done for me. But enough rabble about that. Let's talk about the farm. So in the last episode, I went through all of the details of this, of course, designing it as well. And so I'm not really going to get into that too much. I didn't really run into any problems when building this. And there's just a couple of things that I want to change with the design. So first of all, I want to have some vines and string somewhere up there, so from the bottom you can enderpearl all the way back to the top, and that's because I want to have a nether portal up there. Now I also want to have a nether portal at the bottom as well. I'm going to put them in the exact same position, except not on the y-axis, because one's going to be below the other. And then when you go through them in the nether, I'm hoping that the one at the top is what it will sink to, But it doesn't matter where you are. If you're at the top or the bottom, you'll go back to the same portal. So that way, yeah, it's really convenient. Wherever you are, you can just get back to the Nether. Now, this thing is only going to be accessible through the Nether. I might actually make a little ladder or path to the surface, because I don't know, that's probably a good idea as well. But this thing was built under Joe Hills's area, or behind it at least. So I should go and show you that right now. So it's raining and we don't really want to show that. What is he doing? What is Joe Hills doing? And I'm being attacked. Oh, by a zombie in chains. Ah, the axe. Yes, I do like using the axe. It's good, but here's the thing. It doesn't have the ability of block, which a sword does. So although you get two uses for one, block is quite useful as well. And here come the social zombies. So anyway, the whole reason that we did this in this area was to be in an extreme hills biome. So when I'd done all of my digging with my silk touch efficiency 5, I thought I was going to hit the ground then. It meant we could instant mine everything, and because we're in an extreme hills biome, we would get some emerald ore. So I've since concluded that digging out large areas is fun, but it's probably not the best way to get emerald ore. I think just strip mining is, because all we got was 2 bits, and I forgot that I emptied my ender chest. But yeah, 2 bits of emerald ore from this big area here that we've cleared, so it's definitely not worthwhile doing it like that. However, I think I might open up a shop offering my services as an excavator for people in these biomes, because I know King Daddy DMac is in one of them, obviously Joe Hills is, and if they ever want some underground excavating done, then I would do it for free, if I could keep the smooth stone and like the goodies that I find. So I think that's a fair deal, you know, you want some digging done, I like digging, I could come and do that for you. Anyway, enough rabble, we really need to go and check out the prank, because I have been pranked, but before that I just need to finish this off. So I'm going to add an enderpearl elevator on this side, a nether portal at the top and bottom, and just before I go, the redstone wiring. We don't have to send a signal up from the bottom, we just have a button there on that side, and a pulse extender at the back here. Okay, the netherwart farm is now done. This is the nether portal. If you go through to the other side, I've made this little clearing here, which I think is pretty noticeable, especially with the soul sand and the netherwart, so hopefully people will take note of that if they see it. And I put a little sign up so people know what it is and who's made it as well. That's one of the things we have a problem with on Hermitcraft. You see a new building and then you don't know who's made it. But yeah, this is it. So I put the nether portal in at the top and bottom. It does take you to the top one instead of the bottom, which is good, because that means you can walk in and the netherwarts, if they've grown, you can press the button and harvest. Let's have a look at that. In fact, we can't even see it. More than 2 layers going down. But you can hear the pistons are still activating all the way down to the bottom. So one thing I do need to do is plant some nether warts. Now, I don't have a lot of those, so it's going to take some trips back and forth to get this thing stocked up. But I had to move the redstone so we could fit in the nether portal. So it just goes over here, and I made a different type of pulse extender here, so if that's useful to you, well, then there is another design. So the last thing for me to do is to place down a couple of these blocks, and then it is finished. I'm going to put a sign here that just says press the button to harvest and replant when you're done. But let's go over to my base, and when I say base, I mean the little hermit town base, and see what this prank is about. What on earth is this on my lawn? My nice yellow sandy lawn. Someone has built something here. This is not good. Let's go down and read these signs. So, you done got pranked by the pranksters. That's Pungent and Schism. Enjoy your complimentary gravestone courtesy of us, the pranksters. So, this is apparently a gravestone. Come on down and bury a pet or 10 at the pet cemetery. When you're done with your gravestone, please return the materials. We need them for building things. Don't make us tell you on B-dubs he's a contractor. Okay, so they want the materials back as well. It's a bit cheeky, I think, to come over here and build this and then demand their materials back in return, but I guess they are theirs. And what's this? So please enjoy some complimentary diamonds on us. If there are no diamonds in the chest, somebody stole them. Okay. I've got a feeling there were never any diamonds in that chest at all. Another job well done by the pranksters. Well, I've been pranked, but do you know what? I think the prank's on them, because I don't have any pets to bury at their pet cemetery, you know? So, what can I do? I can't go down there and build a tombstone for nothing. But I don't know. A prank is a prank, and you got to reply to a prank with another prank, which just ends in a never-ending spiral of pranking. But if you guys think I should get these guys back, then leave a comment. Let me know what I could do, because I got some ideas. I don't appreciate this, having a tombstone on the middle of my sandy lawn. So yeah, if you've got any ideas, post a comment in the comment box. I've got some ideas of myself. Maybe we'll get back to them soon. But they did ask for me to bring these materials back to them, so I guess I'll do that first. So this is the pet cemetery. You may remember we stumbled across this area a while ago, and it looks like it's been expanded since then. I was having a look at some of the tombstones. Here lies Garbage. He was terribly, terribly stupid. I don't even know. Actually, I think I do know. It's probably a horse, isn't it? A horse called Garbage. And then over on this side, Boom Goes the Dynamite lies here in rest. Lies here in rest. He was large, slow, and really knew how to take a blow from a creeper. There you go. There's a couple of tombstones here already. But I don't have a pet to bury, so I left a little message down at the front there. Let's throw an ender pearl. Or not, because there's all these trees in the way. Let's go down and have a look at that. Soul sand, no. Okay, so here's the materials from your prank. Be warned, the fate of my response lies in the hands of my viewers. Views. Oh, okay, I made a typo there. Let's put a sign there. And I've got to correct this. Viewers. Oh, that just looks silly. I'll tell you what, I'll sort this out, don't worry. Yeah, so the fate of my response lies in the hands of my viewers. Who knows what they might suggest? P.S. I have no pets to bury. Asuma. So here we are at the area which will be my base. I know a lot of you have been waiting for this. I've been reading the comments, seeing people want me to go and start my own area, and it starts today. Now, we scouted this area in a previous video, but for those of you who missed that, basically my plan here is over time to turn everything that you can see, and all of that is mostly a desert biome with the exception of the plains over there, but we're going to turn this into our own wastelands biome, which means we remove all of the sand and sandstone, and then we're left with like a rock pattern formation, and that will cover the entire view distance that we can see here. So right now I'm standing on what I do believe is pretty much the center of this area, so this is where the majority of my base is going to go. Now my plans for the base is actually to build it all underground. Pretty much all of my projects and stuff that I'm going to be building and doing is going to go underground, and above ground we're going to be turning this into our own biome. So it's going to be a really unique project. I've got tons of ideas which I don't really want to spoil just yet, because I don't know how long it's going to take me to get going. But one thing I've noticed is that there is a desert temple right next to this here, which I do believe is, you know, the center of the area, plus it's right on top of a hill as well. So this would be a good place to actually get started. Now, one thing I do want to do straight away is dig down and create my underground base area, and then put all the chests and stuff like that in. But this will do as a temporary startup. We use this as a structure to put some chests and valuable materials in. Now, one of the things we need to do straight away is just bring over some picks and shovels, some food, and, you know, basic stuff for starting out a base, and I've done none of that. I've actually just run straight over here with nothing at all, which was really not smart, because I've basically got to make the journey all the way back again. And one of the things we'll have to do is set up a nether portal as well, which we'll put here inside the jungle temple for now. So I've got a little bit of traveling to do. I've got to travel all the way back, get some materials, and then head back here again. A large amount of time has passed since I last recorded a clip. I brought back tons of materials, so let's have a quick look at that. You can see each of them in this chest here. And I was just thinking, you know, I've still got quite a lot of supplies back at the spawn area, or the hermit town, because it's not actually the spawn chunks, of course. Oh, we discussed that many times. Just so used to calling it spawn. But I was thinking, you know, having half of my materials here and half of them there isn't necessarily a bad thing, because if ever I want to go and take a break from working on this, because the beginning of this project is going to be a lot of digging, and the kind of tasks that don't really make for interesting episodes, you know. I can't just show myself digging for a whole episode. So having things in two places might not be that bad. I can go back there and do some more projects and build farms and stuff. Now, these chests over here are full of sand, and that's because I have got started on this already. I'm going to show you my progress in a second. But I decided just to do sand first of all, because it's really easy to get lots of it with just the shovel. and that is something I'm a little disappointed with. I've actually gone through 3 shovels so far. If we look in this chest, you can see I've got a broken one here, and I had 2 others as well, and it's so easy just to lose track of the durability meter and going back and forth, mining away at all the sand, and then before you know it, the shovels broke. So I lost 2 of them, which is a bad thing, I think, because I would like to have a large supply of shovels so that I can keep... Oh, and by the way, I call them spades, because over here we call them spades as well, but even though I name them spades, I'm calling them shovels in the video. That is strange. But yeah, I'd like a large supply of shovels so that when I go to the end and repair them all, I can bring them back here and work in it for ages without having to go back to the end. But because we only got a couple of shovels, it means I would have to take more and more trips back and forth. Okay, so first of all, there's one sand block right there that needs removing. Yeah, I started with this hilly area here, right next to the jungle temple. This is where I think the centre of this area is going to go. So if we just hop up here and have a look, I'll show you all the things I've done. There we go, I've dug all of that so far. We'll talk about that in a second. But this is going to be the central area, and what I pictured in my mind with the wastelands biome is it being fairly flat. Now, I don't mind there being hilly areas like this, but around the central area, which is supposedly this, which is all hilly, it goes hilly over there, and oh, it's not good. But I pictured it all being flat, same kind of level as that area over there, and then there being a big gaping hole that you can go down into, and then down below is my base. So that was the idea, but it means I've got to dig away a mountain, which could be pretty crazy. We do have the beacon set up, so we could put haste 2. I was going to say efficiency 2, it's not technically efficiency, but we could put haste on it and then instant mine a lot of it. So I really don't know how to treat it at the moment, but I'm not going to focus on what I'm doing here just yet. I'm going to give myself some time to think about that. What I want to do at the moment is dig a perimeter around the outside. So if we just go back over to here where I'm calling this the center, just stand on this block, you'll see that those chunks back there are unloaded. That goes all the way up to the chunk border and then it stops. And the reason that I did that is because I wanted to figure out the distance in chunks all the way over to the edge. So it means that I can then go around and dig a border around the entire area. So that is my next job to do. That's going to take a long time, as this has already. And this stuff isn't really that interesting, you know. I've shown you the basic plan, and now it's a case of me just getting on and grinding with it. And you can see a portal. Oh, it just unloaded. There's a portal over there in the distance. I need to remove that, actually. There is also a skeleton spawner over there, but it's a little too far away. It might be useful to make that into a trap rather than an XP farm and just go over there and grab bones whenever we need it. But I haven't even explored this area underground yet, which is something we'll be doing soon. I'm going to make a map. In fact, that's something I think I should do now. Make a map so I can see the entire area. And if I get it all in one map, I can sort of figure out the border or the perimeter, and then when I go caving I know how far to go. Although technically lighting up all the caves isn't necessary, because I'm not planning on really building a super efficient mob spawner over here or anything like that. I've got different plans for this place. But enough rambling from now, I've said what I'm going to do. The next thing for me to do is to dig that border around the outside. So I've been calculating how far we need to go in each direction based on having this chunk as the center of our area. And that's when I decided to make a map, and I noticed that where I'm standing right now isn't in the centre of the map. So I thought, well, where is the centre? And it is actually between two chunks. So when you use maps, it is an even grid of chunks. I think it's 8x8 just by looking at it there. So the middle chunks are these 4. So one on either side, which I've dug out even the border of, so you can see it here. And then one on either side here as well. So I think we'll actually make this point right here the center, and then we will do everything around that. So when I expand this map to the next size, it might be big enough for our perimeter, but I got a feeling that it's going to be the size after that, and our perimeter is going to be like halfway out on the map. But anyway, I will go and make this map bigger, and we will find out in a moment. So this map that we're looking at right here, this is 2 times bigger than the one I showed you a moment ago. So that was 8x8 chunks. Then it looked like it doubled to 16x16. And when I came out to the edge here, this was actually the edge of the map. But our draw distance goes a couple of chunks further. You can see it comes all the way out here. So from those 4 chunks in the middle, which my crosshairs are kind of pointing at right now, we're going to go out by 10 chunks in each direction. That's 160 blocks. So we're going to go as far out as here. But you can see that's not the edge of the map. It actually goes a lot further, so we will be able to see the entire area from this map right here, which is pretty cool. Now I'm going to have to dig my trench big enough so that you can actually see it on this map. Now you can see there that our four chunks. We could see it quite clearly a moment ago, and now we can't, so let's just dig this away. I'm going to guess three wide should make it display, although the blocks on the bottom are sandstone and sand, although they all appear as stone there, so that's good actually. That's interesting, sandstone appearing like that on the map. It appears as grey. So if we just dig this back a little bit, can we see that? Might have to wait for it to update and might have to get out of the way as well. And that looks like we can. Yeah, excellent. Okay, so I'm going to go and dig a three wide perimeter around what are now our four chunks in the middle. So as you can imagine, this is taking me a really long time, but I've just noticed something really strange on the map that I'm using. Now, a while ago I tried to make a video on maps, just explaining how they worked with all the new features, and I actually recorded most of the video, and then I got stuck with one thing which I couldn't figure out, which is how it decides what pixel it's going to display on the map. Now, that's easier to do with smaller maps, but with larger ones there's all kinds of strange quirks and things that don't make sense, and it's happening again because this trench here is too wide, and it's too wide going all the way down to the bottom there. And if you look at this, you can see the trench in the green area, but as soon as we come into the sandy area, you can't see it. Which is kind of annoying, but it doesn't matter, I'll just make this thing three wide. And down the bottom, the trench itself is actually four wide. Now, I'm pretty sure I could probably get away with it being three wide, but then it would have to go outside of the perimeter area, because this is on the chunk border, so these chunks here are the edge. Now, as I'm digging along down in this area, I found a village. And I found some piggies as well, which reminded me that I don't have any animals in this area yet. I don't have any of those things that we've had just lying around on Hermitcraft. There's all sorts of things like villagers and pigs that I need to gather up and get in that area. So I think what I need to do some point soon is create some animal pens. I'll probably just start off with like a basic lure and put them in some pens. But at some point I want to dig something underground and give them a proper place to be stored where they're safe. Now, there might be some zombies around here because there's villagers. I came over here and I saw what I think is quartz. It's actually snow, I remember now. Biff has already been here and claimed some of the villagers, so I'm sure he won't mind sharing them with me because I can do some villager breeding or something in the future. It'll be good for a project. But these guys are safe. There were a couple inside this building. Here they are. They look like they're having a little chat, talking about the zombie sieges that keep going on. And over here, you see all this mess of cobblestone. Well, there is actually villages all around there, like there and there. I came over here and some of them were outside, so I just decided to box them in wherever they were standing. Anyway, we got a cow over here. That's good. So there must be some cows in the area. I think that's the next thing I need to do before they all go wandering off and getting themselves killed, which is usually what they do. This area over here is the grassy area that we saw from the center area. And now that it's moved over a little bit further, it means we come further into this area and we sort of encompass this village. But there's actually quite a large amount of this that is in the grassy biome. But I don't think it's going to be a huge problem because we're going to remove all of the dirt on the top and then just convert the stone underneath to look like what the stone on this side will look like when all the sandstone is removed. But this is just such a huge project, you know. I'm realising now the amount of time I've spent digging that trench, and that's just the tiniest. It's not even like 0.1% of the overall project, so who knows how long it's going to take me, but it's nice to have a big project and something to work at now. So anyway, I'm going to head back, drop off these supplies, and I guess by the time I do my next clip, hopefully I would have rounded up a load of animals and finished doing the trench as well. So you know what I'm going to say? I've been digging, no surprise. And I filled up all of these double chests over here and over this side. This one isn't quite full just yet. We need a proper storage area, and we need it soon. And as well as that, we need a place to put our animals, because they're in these little pens outside here. And so I think next episode what we need to do is start working on the central area. You know, I'm going to dig down underground and build most of my base down there. All of this stuff on the surface is just for the Wastelands biome, which I have some plans for. But let me show you what I have done, because I finished doing the border, as you can see here. And I decided I would dig out a big chunk, well, around the area that we had already been digging out in. So I've just made that a bit bigger. It's a pretty good start, I think. But I've been thinking about how boring this kind of is, you know? Like, it's good to see in the long run the Wastelands biome being built, but I can't just dig every episode and say, hey, look at all the digging I've been doing. You know, I broke a couple of shovels, but I kept some other ones. It's just not really that interesting. So I think the way we should approach this is try and do like four chunks every episode. So I was originally thinking maybe work my way down from the top to the bottom, But I think it would be more motivating to start from the inside and make my way out, because that's where the base is going to be. When I say inside, I mean center, of course. You know what I'm talking about. So, oh, wrong key. So then every episode, it would just be a case of, hey, I've done the four chunks. There you go. You can see that bit's been done. And then over time, it will get done. Now, there are a hell of a lot of chunks here, but then it's one of those things, you know. I'm not going to quit doing this anytime soon. So over time, it will get done. We're in it for the long run. And yeah, I think that's a good way to approach it. So let me know what you think about that. But the thing that I'm worried about at this point is that next episode we probably need to start the entrance of the base. And at the moment it's on top of a hill, and I'm not really sure if I should flatten this hill or should I keep it. But I guess I've got time to think about it, and you guys can give me your thoughts and opinions as well. But that is going to be it for this episode. It has been a little bit dull and boring, I know. Just me talking about all the digging that I've been doing, but that's how it's going to start, and we'll get to it quickly, so don't worry about that. But if you want to leave a like on this video, you know it is always appreciated. I find that stuff hugely motivating, seeing the likes and the views. It's kind of like if I put a lot of effort into a video and it's been well liked, then I know that that effort was worthwhile and you guys really enjoyed it. So it's going to be really motivating, especially for a project like this. And we've got a lone cow over here. Did you escape from the pen? I thought I got all of them in there. Maybe one straggled behind. And I've just reminded myself that I need to breed these guys. So anyway, I should go. I should breed these. I'm going to be doing a little bit of tidying up, probably transferring some more materials over in between episodes. But that is it for this one. So if you've enjoyed it, then I will catch you next time, I guess.